Charisma persuasion.
Yeah, board.
Seven.
And so she says, then if you don't want to fight, you can stand and watch. And she darts forward at one of the Doom Guard. And as she does, you feel the other two let go of you, and they go for their swords. And one of them cries out as she knocks him to the ground and begins slashing at him. That's going to bring us to the Doom Guard that was holding a sword at your throat. He's about to move away from you to attack the Sensei. You have a reaction you can use right now if you want to stop him.
No.
No, so you're going to... So.
Actually, wait. No, he's moving to attack her?
He's moving out of your threat range to attack her, yes. I need to stand up for a moment to get my PHB, if you will allow me.
I can't stop you.
Sorry about that. I actually cleaned my room a few weeks ago, so all my books are on shelves, which is weird. Instead of just being just laying around wherever I last used it. So I had to walk across the room to get my player's handbook, which is like, why would you? So, yeah, you have... You're not moving to make to stop him at all? Yes, no?
Yes, I'm going to... Is there any way that I could try to deflect his blow?
You get an attack roll. You get to make an attack action. You can turn that into a grapple action. You can choose to attack him non-lethally, but it has to be an attack action.
Yeah, okay, well, it's not going to do anything because I only rolled an 8.
What AC?
I only rolled an 8 to... I was going to grapple him to keep him from swinging at this.
Well, if you're grappling, that's an opposed check. You're not aiming at his AC, so he gets an athletics check, and he rolled a 5.
Oh.
Did you beat a 5?
I did.
Okay, then he moves in to attack the Sensei, and you immediately... How do you grapple him? How do you get hold of him?
I basically cross both my arms to stop him to block his sword arm.
So you'd have to position yourself in between him and the Sensei to do that. Is that what you're doing?
Yes, that is exactly what I'm doing.
And are you keeping hold of him?
No, I'm using it to stop his blow.
Okay, so he rears back with his sword, and you get your arms up to deflect the blow. Oh, goddammit, I opened the wrong app. That was the Dragon Magazine. That's not what I wanted. Nodal had this big lecture about the ampersand earlier, so that's what I clicked on my thing here.
Listen, if you had read the notes I had provided, you wouldn't have any list to the lecture.
I got the cliff notes, alright? It's fine. Sorry, I gotta look up a thing real quick.
No, but listen, it comes from and per se and.
I don't actually have stats for these characters. This was kind of an impromptu moment, so I have no idea what spells this guy has. That'll teach me to improvise.
Wish.
He has Earthquake.
He has Wish? He does.
Only Wish.
It doesn't matter. None of his spell work. It's just going to show up, Jim, and disappear.
Just give me 2 minutes to throw together a quick spell list for this guy on his turn.
Sure.
That'll give him enough
time. Actually, it's your action, LC Clone. You used your reaction, but now it's your turn.
Chad has come up with a bink card for us. it's really good.
Do I want to know what that space is?
Free space is Mike is muted. I'm gonna put it in Mumble.
This card is really good.
It's really good.
This is a good one. I have to retweet that later.
So yeah, what's LC Clone doing? Sorry about that. Sorry about that.
LC Clone is going to go and try and disarm the Sensate.
The Sensate.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, to do that, you've got to turn your back on the Doomguard. Is that your intention?
Yep.
And at this point, I mean, you see where she's stabbed and slashed this Doomguard on the ground. He's suffered a severe injury, and he's not moving anymore. So go ahead and make an attack. Well, make an attack roll at disadvantage. You don't have to roll particularly well.
15.
So how do you disarm her?
Wrist lock, and once her group ends, then I'll pull a sword from her hand and kick it off away from her.
I mean, do you grab the sword by the blade to get it out of her hand?
Yes.
Okay. Take a point of slashing damage.
Ow, that's fine.
I mean, you've surprised the hell out of her. You step forward, you grab her wrist and turn her arm over. She keeps a loose grip on the sword, and you just, with your other arm, reach out, grab it near the base, pull it from her hand, and you cut your hand open in doing so. And you throw the sword behind you.
And then that's when
furious.
That's when I say, nobody needs to die right now. I insist very firmly.
At that point, there was already a light drizzle in the air, but it seems to coalesce into a very dense fog that's surrounding the whole area. You hear the signer from behind you speak several magic words, and suddenly your vision is totally obscured. You can hardly see a foot ahead of you in front of this fog. And you hear the signer from somewhere behind you say, "There, make good your escape." Almost immediately after that, you hear the sound of retreating footsteps. One of the Doomguard, because she killed one of them. One of the Doomguard breaks and runs from in the opposite direction of the prison. The Sensate is probably going to stab you.
Fine.
Through the fog, you see very swiftly the glint of a knife that the Sensate has drawn from somewhere on her person, and she's slashing it at you now. She's furious at you. What's next?
Did it miss the knife?
It missed, yeah. It missed.
Disarm that.
Oh, wait, no, I'm sorry. You don't have an action yet. There's another Doomguard still here. So you have the Sensate in front of you, the Doomguard behind you, and you're having difficulty splitting your attention between both. But you're able to use the fog to your advantage, and so far neither of them have managed to land an attack. You've managed to duck out of the way. And now it's your turn.
Disarm that knife.
Okay. Roll at disadvantage.
Yeah, I did. And I rolled like garbage.
What'd you get?
I got a 7.
No, not good enough. You attempt to reach out and get the knife, but at this point she's wise to your moves. And she's cursing you. Saying, "I stepped in to defend you. Now you bring violence to me? You should stand against these Doomguard thugs."
I don't want to hurt anyone.
You hear the footsteps of the signer leaving. He's given you the opportunity to retreat, and he is taking it. And And again, she's coming at, slashing at you with her knife, but you're backing out of the way. And then the Doomguard at your back. Ooh, that'll hit. LC Clone has an AC of 15. That barely 15. Hits. 9 piercing damage. I'm sorry, slashing damage. He had a longsword. I'm sorry, 10 slashing damage. And you feel the cut across your back. The sting of blood. And the Doomguard says kind of merrily from behind you. Says, "You're seeing things my way now, love. Let's take him in. We'll split the reward between us." To which the Sensate replies, "After I've put him down, you're next." And it's Elsie Clone now.
Disengage.
Okay.
And bolt.
bolt where?
Bolt into the crowd.
So you're headed back towards the prison to disappear in the crowd there?
Yeah.
Okay. And as you bolt away, I mean, the fog thins as you step out of the radius of the spell, and behind you, you hear the clashing of metal. And running down the street, make me a dexterity saving throw real quick.
That dexterity saving throw is a 11.
11. As you're going down the street towards the prison, you see a group of hardheads of Harmonium. Three of them. A patrol. So they have their man catcher running towards the altercation. And for a split second, you try to dive out of the way to make sure that they don't see you. But you're not quick enough. And they meet your gaze. And one of them breaks off coming in your direction. The one with the man catcher. So now, okay. I gotta roll initiative for him. And he rolled, like, even worse poop. Like, the kind of poop that poop poops.
Like, double poop? Poop times two, yep.
And he shouted you to halt. In the name of the law. So he's coming in your direction. The other two are heading towards the fog cloud.
Stop. Hold my hands up.
Okay. You hear a couple more. The sounds of swords clashing behind you. The two hardheads make their way into the fog cloud and join the altercation there. You hear orders being barked. Curses being thrown from all three parties. The hardhead coming towards you makes no... makes no move to apprehend or attack you. But he asks you what transpired. What's going on?
I'll give that three, the Doom Guard tried to apprehend me. I committed no crime, and they've, and
so
then
you're the one who shouted.
Some of the crowd. Yes.
So the Mercy Killers have made very clear that they're not paying out rewards.
That's funny, because they said that they were going to call in for a reward.
He looks you head to toe. Says, "What are your colors, boy?"
Scotsman.
You do well to wear them these days.
I'll nod. I'll make a note of that in the future. Thank you.
And then he goes, passes you by. By now you hear the sounds of combat beginning to die away. It sounds like the two hardheads have stepped in and apprehended the Sensate and the remaining Doomguard. So where do you go after that? Where are you headed when you leave the prison?
Let's see, prison. Let's see, what would be closer, Mahogany Shop or Serenity set, Serenity's Kip?
They're both on the other side of Sigil. It's a long walk either way.
All right, and I'll start limping that way.
Okay. Did anybody not get an evening action? I think we covered everybody, didn't we?
This is the same evening as the concert.
Yeah.
Yes, while he was while he had that altercation in the street, Riot was performing with the band.
Elsa Clone had kind of a long evening action.
Well, we had to resolve combat, so. I mean, you're the one who said, I'm going to go to the most volatile place in the city for my action. So, Serenity, you get back to Sigil that night after your long journeys through the calm, tranquil, rocky Bitopian city or Bitopian region that you hail from. You spent the day in meditation. You met a bear. It was cool. And returning to Sigil.
What is the bear's name?
Why would a bear have a name?
I have a name.
Well, to be fair, you've only met one bear the entire campaign, and it had a name.
So there you go.
You step out of the portal into the slags, and there's a huge crowd. Standing, it doesn't seem to be a violent crowd, but you know that that can change very, very quickly in Sigil. There's a Githzerai standing on a soapbox. And you know it's a soapbox because it's actually a huge carriage that has been overturned and then painted on the side the word soapbox in several different languages. Standing on it is a Githzerai man with a topknot. And he's wearing very official-looking clothes. He's wearing a very ornate cloak. Doesn't look like anything related to the nobility of Sigil. It looks like how you would imagine a fairy tale prince in a children's book to dress.
He's the Chaos Man.
And that's how he's dressed. Oh no, he is a Chaos Man. You see the symbol of the Chaos Atex emblazoned on the doublet that he's wearing. And he's addressing the crowd very angrily. Like chastising them, calling them rabble-rousers and ne'er-do-wells, saying that they're bringing dishonor and shame on the glorious and ancient order of the Chaos Men. And this is the scene that you step out of the portal right into the street. This is what you're getting. I gotta let my dog, he's been barking for like 7 minutes now and it's driving me crazy. So let's take five.
All right.
I know. I'm being an asshole because Destil hasn't had any time to play yet today. But I gotta let my dog in, and I'm gonna get a drink of water, and I'll see you guys in 5 minutes.
Yeah,
5 minutes.
Okay. He's upset because they're doing a really shitty job at rioting.
But no, that's the scene when you step out. So what is it that you're doing?
Yeah, she'll just stand at the edge of the group. Are they wearing Osman colors?
they're Chaos Men. So some of them are flaunting that fact. Others are not. Others are standing on their hands. But they're regarding the Githzerai very intently. Like they're.
And I take it a number of them are wearing colors that match no faction.
Oh yeah, but none of them are wearing colors of another faction.
Okay.
Very pointedly, But the one thing that this entire crowd has in common is that they're all listening to this man. Some of them are shouting arguments back. There's some disagreement going back and forth, but they all seem to be hanging on his words. They all seem to be listening to him. They're not just here to cause trouble. Are you making any effort to not be seen?
Yeah, I'll try and just sort of blend into the background. Should I make a stealth check?
Yes, please. And are you wearing Cypher's colors?
Yeah.
Okay. How so?
Probably just inside the trim of her cloak.
So is it something that a casual observer would be able to see on her? Just looking?
Probably not. She'd have to probably open her cloak a little bit.
Okay.
That's a 5.
A 5 for stealth?
On stealth.
So how are you trying to hide? Just like kind of step back into a doorway?
Yeah, no, just kind of step back through the doorway I just exited through the gate from. Just listen.
The man standing up on the quote-unquote soapbox catches you immediately as you try to step back away. And you lock eyes with him for a moment. And he holds his hand out and says, "You there, my fine Genasi lady. Step forward and make yourself known. Slink not in the shadows. Be not ashamed of who and what you are."
I'll step forward somewhat awkwardly.
And he beckons you to join him up on his soapbox.
Okay, sure.
And as you're approaching, you see in one hand he's holding this gaudy gilded scepter, and in the other he's holding this scroll case. And you climb up onto the soapbox, and he hands both objects to you, and then very swiftly takes the cloak that he's wearing, the heavy, ornate cloak, and drapes it across your shoulders, pats you on the back, and said, "Good, I was getting tired of that. You take the rest from here." And then he climbs down and walks away. And now the whole crowd is looking intently at you.
Yes, but we should not go quietly into the night. We should make a lot of noise. Get some bands, maybe some pots. You know, whatever comes to mind, really.
That's not what you were saying a moment ago. A moment ago, you were saying we should all turn ourselves in.
No, no, you should turn yourself into a noisy, rabble-less crowd. Inflection is important.
I didn't catch the last part. What was that?
Into, not in. Inflection is important.
And you see some kind of understanding dawn on several of their faces. Oh, I get it now. And some of them do start making noise. You hear the sound of a kazoo somewhere in the back of the crowd. You hear someone start banging on a pot. But they're looking to you for direction as you start to incite this crowd.
I hadn't thought this far ahead. All right, this way. And I'll lead them in whatever random direction I happen to be facing.
Okay, well, roll a d8, see what direction you're going.
Serenity becomes Kelian for a
night. We'll say that one is north. Well, north in Sigil, but whatever.
North.
So you start marching off towards the Hall of Records. Going through the alleyways of the slags. And the Faded are out in droves tonight. It looks like they are on a mission. A lot of mid-level clerks and things, the kind of Faded members that you typically wouldn't see out and about in the streets. Typically, they'd be holed up in their gigantic headquarters, pushing pencils and shuffling papers around. And 20 or 30 minutes of marching through the alleys of the slags, coming out through this the sandstone district, through the markets and shops there, coming out onto Pride Street, and you find yourself headed toward the Hall of Records. And the crowds of Faded who are... they're not just milling about purposely. It looks like they're comparing notes. There's a lot of paperwork out on the streets, even this late at night. It looks like a lot of them are exhausted after a long day of doing whatever it is the Faded do. So are we marching straight up into the Hall of Records with this crowd?
Sure.
Seemed like a good idea at the time.
Yeah, it seemed like an excellent idea, I suppose. And...
Question, am I at the Hall of Records?
Are you?
Do you want I don't know.
That's what I'm asking
could be.
You.
I figured I would be if I'm... if I'm saving...
You were that evening.
Yeah. So, is it past that?
This is a nighttime action, yeah. This is late at night.
Oh, well...
So, I mean, you were there in the evening.
Cool. Yeah. Bring it.
So, where are you in the hall? Are you still up in the office? Or are you heading home? Because if you're still way up in the offices, chances are you won't see any sign of this crowd approaching. The hall of records is 40 stories.
Yeah, I'd figure I'd be in my office.
Okay, but if it was your intention to try to interact with this Serenity's new friends, then you won't be able to do that from your office. You won't even know they're there.
Yeah, I wouldn't be able to do that. Okay.
But if you were...
So I have my signs of office are a scepter, a cloak, and a crown. Is that correct?
No, not a crown. You have a scepter. And holding it, there's no weight to it. Okay. It's not made of metal. It just looks like gold. It looks like it's been magically enchanted to look like a scepter. And all... it's probably a stick or something similar. On the other hand, you're holding a scroll case, which, again, has no weight to it. It must be empty. There's nothing in it. But the cloak that's draped across your shoulders feels very heavy indeed.
All right, I'm going to grab the Chaos Man to my right, hand him the scepter, point to the east, and say go that way. I'm going to take the scroll case from my left hand, grab the one on my left, and tell him to go that way.
What do you do with the cloak?
Oh, you're causing a schism.
I'll continue marching or wearing the cloak.
So, your group kind of splits off into several different groups, marching in different directions. And the Fated, who are standing around... Let me actually get the Hall of Records map here. That seemed like it might be pertinent all of a sudden.
Gonna lie. I have a feeling at some point Kelian is gonna have him out of his office.
I mean, is it your intention to interact with this group eventually? Is that what you're wanting?
Not
to
unless
do?
Something ends. So,
all right, let me load up the map here. This is why I've got all the Factol headquarters maps. I mean, that's.
Because stupid shit like this happens.
Is it not? Oh, I'm posting in the wrong goddamn link. I'm a smarty man.
You're smarty man.
I'm smarty man. That's. I feel like that should be on the bingo card. Brick tries to load the wrong link. There it is. Okay, so you're coming up from the south. So the Rowan Academy of Training entrance. So, the actual center tower, the Hall of Records proper, is this giant 340-foot structure built up out of the town. And you're coming in through the south here. So, this group of Fated kind of meets up on the street here, right at the entrance. Many of them are armed, and as you approach, a lot of them draw their weapons.
We'll just continue down Crystal Dew Lane, then. Just to sort of grab a Simpson going into the building, putting his hat on the rack, turning right around and taking it off.
Nice. So, as you turn, though, you notice some of the men with you don't follow you any longer. You hear one of them lets out a cry and starts banging his pot violently. Six or seven of them break off from your group, which is traveling down Crystal Dew Lane, and running towards the Fated, meeting them head on. And now there is combat there.
What are they armed with?
Who, the Fated or the Chaos Men?
The Chaos Men that decided some of them to have Fated.
Yeah, some of them have actual weapons, staves or daggers. Some of them have rolling pins. One of them has the big pot and spoon he's been banging it with. A lot of them are just going at it with fists. But as the group that you're standing with sees that happen, and sees the Fated kind of confusedly be ambushed by this group of just crazy Chaos Men, they're kind of looking back and forth, not sure what to do. To whether to keep following you or break off, because that looks like more fun.
I'm going to yell, this way, and continue down to Dew Lane.
Okay. And most of the ones that were already following you continue to do so. But the ones who are already in the fight do not disengage, do not break away. So, Kelian, after a long evening in the Hall of Records, sir. When it's time to turn in for the night, you're coming out of the faction member entrance here. There seems to be some kind of commotion at the southern entrance.
I guess I'm going to go investigate.
And getting close to this southern entrance, you see a melee between six or seven badly armed Chaos Men and a at least twice that many faded militiamen. I mean, they seem to have things well in hand. Whatever this attack was, it seems to have been dealt with rather quickly.
I'll watch on curiously.
Okay.
But I'm not gonna do anything.
Are you carrying a weapon right now?
Yeah.
What kind of weapon?
Probably a short sword.
Okay. And you feel a hand on your shoulder, and it's one of your fellow clerks. And he too, he's got a sword in his hand. He said, "They're coming up the other gate. Come on, let's go." And begins running off in the direction of that faction member entrance.
Really? We have people to take care of this for us.
And he looks at your short sword and says, "Yes, us. Let's go."
Okay. Kalian trots along.
The cat's nowhere to be seen at the moment.
Yeah, it's unfortunate.
You arrive at the faction member entrance, and looking out of the gate, you see a more organized, on the part of the faded, about 10 or 12 faded members are standing outside of the gate proper, armed with weapons. And then you and the man who grabbed you and then a couple of his fellows are coming up behind. Because the force that's walking by this gate is much larger than the one that you just saw. And leading it is Serenity, wearing a heavy, gaudy, royal-looking cloak.
Kelian's eyes go wide at that sight. Very, are you kidding me?
Like, this is a thing. This is a thing that's happening now?
Pretty much.
What's Serenity's passive perception here? Only 11.
Okay. Not great. Yeah.
So yeah, you just see the gaggle of the faded standing at the gate, and they look like they're ready for anything.
I'll just try and kind of make sure, try and make it keep moving and hope that none of my chaos men attract any attention.
Unfortunately, you hope in vain. Because as you march by, a couple more of your chaos men break away and charge the gate, leaving you with about 5 or 6. And Kelian, from your point of view, you watch as these chaos men led by Serenity, several of them break away and charge the gate and are immediately received by the faded standing there. The man next to you and some of his fellows loose arrows over the walls. And I mean, within a matter of moments, the chaos men are cut down.
I'm content to watch all of this down, sure.
There seems to be the question now. So what's Serenity doing? Just continuing to march down the road?
Yeah, just she's picked up the pace a little bit at this point.
Okay.
After they started shooting arrows.
At that, one of the fellows inside says, "The rest of them are going around the eastern wall. What do we look like at the main entrance?" And there's some back and forth about how the militia is bolstering their defenses at each of the entrances, and so if they're looking to make an attack there, they'll be able to rout the rest of them. And it seems like the plan is to give chase if any of them try to retreat. Does Kelian want any involvement in that?
No, he really doesn't.
Okay, so
there's a time and a place for murder, and it's not right now.
So, just to get this clear, when he saw that Mahogany was in trouble, he swung in like a conquering hero. But now that it looks like Serenity's in trouble, he's like, you know what? Nah.
He doesn't know what. He doesn't know what.
Me and Kelian have an understanding.
Kelian has no idea what's going on now, other than Serenity is apparently leading a rebel army. So he's trying to figure it out. I mean, because his natural response is to go chase after Serenity and stab her in the head. But he kind of doesn't want to do that. There's more valuable... Serenity is more valuable alive than dead, so he's going to watch.
So when you say watch, are you waiting inside the walls, or are you going to go out and regard the group?
I think he's going to go out and regard the group.
Okay. And that's easy enough, because when you step out of the faction member entrance here, you join a group of 10 or so members of the Faded, members of the militia that Rowan has been building up, actually. He's been emphasizing martial training in the years since he took over the Hall of Records. Many of the dormitories and whatnot on the Records grounds, staying there is contingent on taking up arms in defense of the faction. And so Serenity's picking up the pace. Is Serenity broken out into a run yet?
Not yet. I think if she actually starts running, she's a little afraid they'll try and run her down. So
okay. It's
just a brisk march now.
So where is she marching to?
What do I have on my right and left of this road?
Let's go back.
Are there
to
any
the,
branches that take away from the Hall of Records?
Yes. Let's go back to the big sigil map here.
Then away from the Hall of Records.
You rolled a one. That's funny. That's the Hall of Speakers, not the Hall of Records. There's Hall of Records. So, yeah, coming up around the eastern side of the Hall of Records, you've got alleys and streets that lead off through this neighborhood here, off towards Stump Street.
I'll lead them into an alley. I will take 6 silver from my belt pouch, which is the money I stole from the last Chaos Man I encountered.
Okay.
I will split it up between my 6 remaining followers, tell them to they've had a good night, go get something good to drink. And I will take the cloak, put it in my backpack, and continue on my way.
Once Serenity is out of sight, Kelian will try and go after them.
Okay. Serenity, 2 of your followers look very, very confused at the end of all of this when you hand them the silver
piece.
That's
the Chaos Man's natural state.
The other 4 looks like they give every indication that what you just did makes perfect sense, and they look extremely content. And they scatter in different directions into various alleyways. So by the time that Kelian and the other members of the Faded arrive, it's just you in the alley. So my next question is, do you...
I wasn't sticking around. I was a cast pass without a trace and
okay.
Sneak off into the night.
Kelian and Serenity, roll both your roll an initiative check. Let's see which of those 2 things happens first.
Oops.
Kelian... No, it's just straight off initiative check. It'll be good.
13 for Serenity.
So the Faded arrive at the mouth of the alleyway before Serenity is able to cast the spell. Because you had to stop and get out your belt pouch and quickly dole out silver and then make sure the other castmen were getting away. So just as you're preparing to cast the spell, you see the Faded, one of which is Kelian now that you you recognize very clearly, coming into the alleyway. It's not a dead-end alleyway, though. There are several exits from here. Lots of ways you can go, squeezing between buildings or however the spirit moves you.
Yeah, no, that's absolutely just going to move as fast as she can in whatever direction is not towards the Faded.
Still
kind of wink at Kelian if she sees him, though.
You're going to wink at Kelian?
Yeah, and then run.
Are you still casting Pass Without Trace?
Not if they can see what I'm doing, if I can get out of sight.
Okay. Moving out of their field of vision is easy enough. Go ahead and make me a stealth check if you're trying to remain hidden from their field of sight.
And this is a plus 10?
Not if you didn't cast Pass Without Trace, no.
Oh, no. Well, I'm going to get out of sight and cast a spell. That was the idea.
Well, you got to hide before you can cast a spell.
That's clear.
Okay. Oh, I see what you're saying. You're not going to hide. Gotcha. So you're going to cast the spell. You don't need to make a stealth check then.
Okay.
And if at all possible, Killian's going to do his best to lead the crowd away. Like, misdirection. Like, oh, he went this way when he really went the other way.
Okay. Make a charisma deception. That'll do it.
23.
Okay.
On point tonight.
You duck down the alley and saying, I think she went this way, and then quickly juke a different direction. You don't see any trace of Serenity anywhere, but within a few moments, you manage to get the Faded into a U-turn. And now they're headed back towards the Hall of Records, which they recognize immediately. But the consensus is that they just lost her. She must have gotten away. Nobody's blaming you for it.
Yeah.
Serenity.
Curse that mysterious woman I don't know.
Yes.
What's next?
Like I said, cast Pass Without Trace and move silently across the streets back to my dorm room.
Done. Go ahead and make that stealth check. Make it at advantage. At advantage with your plus 10.
Stealth. 28.
Not a problem. You hear sounds of Kelian say, "Oh, I think she went this way." And you hear the sounds of their moving the opposite direction. So very easily you manage to cast the spell and get away from them. What do you do with the cloak?
I'm going to hang it up inside my kip. I'm going to put it on the back of a chair.
Gruffler does not approve of the opulent, fake-looking cloak. And he certainly does not approve of the Chaos Man symbol etched into it. But he doesn't say anything about it. He just gives you a dirty look.
Son, I am...
He just sort of gruffles.
He gruffles. Does anybody else want to take a nighttime action? Late at night?
Like I said, I would be limping toward either Serenity's Kip or the Mahogany Shop.
Mahogany Shop would be closer from the direction you were coming from. You'd be coming through the gymnasium district first. Or no, I'm sorry, no. Serenity's Kip is near the gymnasium.
Then I would arrive at Serenity's Kip.
We're both pretty near the gymnasium.
So. I thought Mahogany was over in the clerk's ward over here.
No, I'm halfway between the gymnasium and the market and the bazaar.
And the bazaar. Oh, okay, so yeah, you would come to Mahogany's shop first then. Because Serenity's right across the street from the gym.
Then knock on Mahogany's door.
Mahogany, you have another visitor.
Mahogany can't fucking believe the night he's having. And he's sure it's the most preposterous night out of anyone in this group. He heads to go see who it is.
And it's Elsie Clone being bloodied and fucked.
He looks like he's been in a fight.
Well, come in. Suppose you're here for healing, then.
I'll sit down. I would not. That wouldn't go amiss, but I just needed a place to rest.
What happened to you?
The Doomguard, or what I assume the Doomguard. I don't know. That point's still out. The jury's still out on that point.
Mahogany picks up a table from the table, shrugs, and takes it into the kitchen to fill it up again. He's sure there's still some of that tea left. Why were the Doomguard looking for you? You're not an in-depth.
No, but they thought it was. And speaking of which, you happen to have any wood carvings of the Godsman's emblem, would you?
I'm sure I could make one for you.
Please
yeah,
do.
I don't have one.
I'll gladly pay you for
it. Mahogany will just go back to the shop, rummage around. How big do you need it?
I'll look down at myself for a second. Then I'll take off my sash, tie it around my shoulders. It's kind of up around my shoulder. And then say about this big, and I'll hold my thumbs and my fingers in a circle.
Alright, and he goes, and looking at you, I'm guessing quicker is better.
I'll nod.
So I'll just quickly throw some stuff in there and carve him off one.
Okay.
How much do I owe
some
you?
Scrap.
Maybe dexterity and tools check. Your woodworking.
Looks like 19 plus 5 is 24.
Okay. So, my next question is, how familiar would Mahogany be with the symbol of the Godsman? Without any kind of reference for it.
He's seen it, because, I mean, people wear it around every day.
Yeah.
You could probably get it, like, mostly right, and he would ask Elsie Clone for any finer details once he's got the base scribed out.
Okay.
And I will gladly provide.
So yeah, it takes you the better part of an hour, but you manage to get kind of a crude badge made for LC Clone.
During this hour, I'm going to take the opportunity for a short run and burn 2d8.
Okay.
And get my hit point back.
So yeah, he makes you a wooden crest with the Godsman emblem etched into the front of it. Out of what kind of wood? Because I know that's important to you.
What is the most appropriate wood for a godsman?
You actually have a large supply of gray wood from the gray waste back there that you ordered 6 months ago but forgot about.
I don't think he'd be too happy with that.
I'll shake my head. No, I don't think so.
That doesn't seem like... If a bleaker came to me and wanted some a pen made, that's the wood I would use.
Yeah.
But it's not godsman.
See, here's a sense where I just trolled Nodal, and then I think he immediately turned around and trolled me back. So mark off your bingo cards, people.
So yeah, I just burn my hit dice to gain my health mostly back. I'm now one quarter full.
So what kind of money changes hands? Do you charge him for it?
Yeah, that's what I'm. Yeah, I'm like, what do I owe you?
Whatever you think is right.
I'll give him 5 silver.
All right, I'll take it.
Hey, and what's next for you two?
I'm gonna heal him up. No charge for this.
Oh, okay. Well, then I'll end one berry, and I'll be hunky dory.
All right. Well, I'll hand him one.
20. And then while all this is going on, I'll tell him the story of what went down at the Doomguards at the prison. And one thing that stuck out to me is that they said that they were looking for a reward, but then the Harmonians said that they weren't offering a reward.
Yeah, they probably just assumed.
I don't know, that something doesn't feel right about that.
You think we should look into it? Who did they say that they were going to? The Harmonium?
I shook my head, I have no idea. But I did not want to find out, so... That's why...
And I'm going to look at it, I'm going to say, are you sure this is because they thought you were an Indep? Did it look like they were looking for you particularly?
Well, they weren't stopping anyone else, so it's possible.
I think our activities earlier have led to this. They were probably just using the confusion of the moment to get you.
I'll nod. Seems likely.
We should probably talk to Riot. She would know the people to ask if there's a bounty on your head.
Yeah. Well, she's probably having the time of her life or wherever the hell she's playing music at right now, so... Go see her in the morning,
I tell you what, why don't you spend the night here?
Sure.
And tomorrow we'll go see her.
Yeah. Yeah, good call. I'll pull a chair up and facing the door against the wall, back my back to the wall, facing the door. Arms and just nod off, sort of.
I love it. He sleeps like the professional. Is anybody else taking a nighttime action?
Kelian will kill if you do, sure. A couple of rioters at the Hall of Records, but.
Now. Okay. I mean, that'll burns out surprisingly quickly.
Oh, okay.
It was a couple of just a weird rabble that bled out from the hive for no clearly delineated reason. The description of the mysterious leader is circulated amongst the Hall of Records. And the concern now is, like, do we even bother tracking her down? Was this even a threat? Was this Chaos Man retaliation for something? Or was it just the randomness of... So people aren't really sure what to make of what happened at the gates of the Hall.
They were probably delivering a pizza.
I can see that. I can totally see that.
Yeah, I'll let the chaos sort itself out then. No action then.
Okay. Most of the chaos men who charged the gates, most of them were killed during the attack. A few of them were surrendered. A few of them were taken prisoner, disarmed, and brought into the Hall of Records. Doesn't really have holding cells. They don't really have a prison area, but they have secure locations on the site where people can be held temporarily, and that's where they're taken for now.
Okay.
Pending decision on what to be done. So your nighttime action is to...
Not do anything.
Not do anything. Okay.
Yeah. Go home, rest, play with the cat.
And the cat's at home when you return, when you get there.
Excellent. Excellent.
It begs for food. What are you feeding this cat?
Pretty good cat food.
Like, where did you procure cat food, and what do you mean by cat food?
The cat food store?
I mean, let's be clear, you're not walking into Publix and buying you some fancy feasts. You're in Sigil. So, I mean, are you going to try to procure, I mean, you haven't done anything for it yet, but are you trying to procure like a bucket of fish heads?
I figured I did stuff for it as part of, I returned to Sigil, and now... when we split up a party. Okay. But yeah, I would buy fish heads for it. Only the best for this cat.
What's the name of the cat?
Yeah, what's the cat's name?
Oh, I haven't decided yet. I wasn't expecting a cat, so I gotta figure that one out.
Well, we gotta give the people their bingo card spot somehow, so how are we gonna do this?
Okay, so go ahead and mark off a piece of gold to... Okay. For cat supplies, this you had to set up a daily delivery of fresh milk.
Mm-hmm.
The bottle will come around once a day. That costs you a few silvers a month. The you bought it a nice little bed, scratching post.
Excellent.
A little toy with a bell inside of it. And then fresh fish for the cat to eat.
Good.
Easy enough. So that expenditure is going to be 1 gold piece per month. Mark that on your sheet somewhere.
Sure.
I'm not sure where you would mark it, but yeah, you have a cat expenditure now. The cat has given very little indication that it is aware of your existence when you are together in the house. It kind of just totally ignores you. It seems to be a little healthier looking now. I mean, you haven't had it groomed. It still kind of looks disheveled. Its fur, of course, is still matted and in disarray. And it still walks with a limp. But it seems to be healthier. You put some meat on its bones. It has no outward injuries. And it spends most of its time either just curled up in its bed or stalking the baseboards around the bottom floor of your house, looking for mice, presumably.
Perfect. I like this working relationship we have.
So the next morning, Riot.
Mm-hmm.
You wake up in Ronrig's kip.
Yep.
And what happens?
Okay, I thought you were going to tell me something terrible happened.
Well, let me first clarify. Mahogany and Ciclone, you were going to go to find Riot in the morning?
Yeah.
Okay, mm-hmm. Then in that case, right, you were awoken by the sound of knocking at Ronrug's door.
All right, I'll wait for someone else to go answer it.
And you wait a minute, and you wait 2 minutes. The knocking...
All right, I'll get up, I'll go answer it.
And as you're walking towards the door, you hear Ronrug call down and says, "Can you answer the goddamn door?"
Yes, sir, right there, something closing. I guess answer the door.
And it's Mahogany and Elsie Clone at the door. Elsie Clone has recently bandaged wounds. Where did we decide Ronrug lives? In the lower ward, I would presume.
Probably. I don't remember if we actually made a decision there.
I don't either now. Yeah, we'll say the lower ward. That's a good spot.
Yeah, I want to pick a street.
He's not shitty enough to live in the Hive.
Oh wow, the Alley of Dangerous Angles actually on the map. That's cool. That's one of the... and Ragpicker Square, my goodness.
What what's her name? Liv.
Well, those are locations from Planescape Torment, so whoever made this map must have played Torment.
Nice.
Because the they're in a book somewhere.
This whole area around the around the dead district, actually, around the mortuary.